patient reader, I must really conclude this opening chapter. It has only to be signed. Stop. Misconceived formulation. With a signature there must be no joking. Otherwise the same thing will happen to you as happened once before in one of the countries of Central Europe, when you were forced to pay 10 years rent for a house you occupied for only 3 months, simply because you had signed a paper obliging you to renew the lease for the house each year. After this and many similar life experiences, I must, in any case as regards my own signature, be very, very careful. Very well, then. He who in childhood is called Tadek, in early youth, Yargi, later, the Black Greek, in middle age, the Tiger of Turkestan, and now, not just anybody, but the genuine Monsieur, or Mr. Gurdjieff, or the nephew of Prince Mukransky, are finally simply a teacher of dancing. Chapter 2. Prologue. Why Beelzebub was in our solar system. IT was in the year 223 after the creation of the world by objective time calculation law, as would be said here on the Earth, in the year 1921 after the birth of Christ. Through the universe flew the trans-space communication ship Karnak. Having left the spaces of the Soferoxata, that is, the Milky Way, it was flying from the planet Paratus to the solar system, Pandet's Note, the sun of which is called the Pole Star. On this trans spaceship was Beelzebub with his kinsmen and close companions. He was on his way to the planet, the Vosverdender, to a conference in which he had consented to take part, at the request of friends of long standing. Only the remembrance of these old friendships had sensed him to accept the invitation, for he was no longer young, and so lengthy a voyage with its inevitable hardships was by no means an easy task for one of his years. A short time before this voyage, Beelzebub had returned home to the planet Paratus, the place of his arising, and far from which, due to circumstances not depending on his essence, he had passed many years of his existence in conditions alien to his nature. These long years of an existence unsuited to him, and with all the perceptions and experiences foreign to his essence, not failed to leave a noticeable mark on his common presence. Time itself had by now inevitably aged him, and these unaccustomed conditions of planet Mars, where he organized his existence in a less tolerable one of his chief occupations was setting up a venture observatory on the planet Mars for the observation of remote points of the universe as well as the jurisdiction of existence of beings on neighboring planets, and this observatory of his, by the way, later became well known and even famous everywhere in the universe. Although the solar system Mars had been neglected because of its remoteness from the